Lived in the kingdom of Galamir, a sorcerer named Zerok. This arrogant, pitiless man hated his fellow citizens for their simple and peaceful ways. So he raised an army of demons and set out to take the realm for his own. The king's champion, Sir Daniel Fortescue, led the militia in the battle against this unholy horde. Songs are still sung of how he spearheaded the charge deep into the accursed multitude, how demons fell before him like wheat before the scythe, and how at last, though mortally wounded, he destroyed the sorcerer utterly. Fortescue went down in history that day as the hero of Galamir, and a time of peace began, which was to last for 100 years. And then the sorcerer returned.
Thank you. It has risen again, Sir Daniel Fortescue, see? The hero of Gallowmere who fell at the first charge. The fog of war and the shrouds of time conspire to turn the arrow fodder into the savior of the day. But we knows better. Let it alone. Fate has given it a second chance. A chance to forget the ignoble truth. A chance to defeat Zarok and live up to the legend. We hopes it does well. It has risen again, Sir Daniel Fortescue, see? The hero of
Any treasure that you find will be added to your coin total. Coins are used to buy items from the greedy merchant gargoyles. You will find life bottles throughout Gallowmere. They contain the same magic that rose you from your slumber and will raise you from the dead once again. When your life is low, using this bottle will help you feel a little better. And remember to fill it when you can. When you're ready to leave this crypt, you'll find an exit at the end of the hall. To unlock the gates, you must find a runestone and place it in the ornate hand set next to the doorway. You must be out of shape after 100 years lying on your back. Use the crypt to get to grips with your new lease on life.
Let it alone.
Some weapons contain powers and abilities beyond the ordinary. Be sure to test every weapon to discover their secondary abilities. Some weapon abilities are immediate, and some may need a bit of time to charge before they realize their full potential. During your travels through Galamere, you will collect many items. To see your items or to use one, review your inventory. In it, you will also find your Book of Galamere, which will keep a record of the denizens you've encountered and bestow you with keen insights that only a disembodied voice could provide. Down Zerok by retracing his diabolical odyssey through Galamere. You can spot the exits from an area by looking out for his stinking trail of magic slime. Welcome back to your beloved Galamir. The stinking dead have risen up to dance with the lifeless living, and they want to do it over your dead body. That small light following you around is a wisp. The heroes of the Hall are not supposed to intervene in mortal affairs, but when they heard that Sir Daniel Fortescue had a shot at redemption, well, they decided to give you a hand with your depth perception. He will circle enemies, helping you direct your ranged attacks, but he'll also let you know what things might merit a closer look. Zombies get you down. Tend those wounds by stepping into this fountain of rejuvenation. Sometimes it may be useful to view the world from a different point of view. Be sure to take a moment from time to time to enjoy the beauty of our beloved Galamir. Keep your eye peeled for anything interesting. Remember, nothing remains hidden under the gaze of an angel. The object here is the chalice. Every time you dispatch an enemy with a soul, the chalice fills a little more. Fill the chalice and then collect it, and you will be worthy of visiting the Sacred Hall of Heroes to claim a new weapon. There is a chalice to be found in every region of Galamir. They are all hidden or well guarded. Only a true hero will collect the full set. The living world lies beyond these skull gates. The master of the hilltop mausoleum, the stained glass demon, has possession of the skull key.
Hey.
Free to have a paddle in the shallow water, but don't be tempted to go for a swim. Buoyancy can be a problem for those of a dead disposition.
Welcome to the Hall of Heroes, where the bravest warriors from history spend eternity, feasting, singing, and arm wrestling. If they think you're worthy enough, you may be able to persuade them to give you a new weapon. Welcome.
To pay homage to the heroes, stand in front of their designated statues and await spiritual guidance.
It's me, Canny Tim. Does the battle go well? How I wish I could fight at your side again, sir. But hold, you could take my crossbow. It's got rapid fire and it can ricochet the darts off walls to shoot around corners. I used it at the Battle of Galamir. After you were slain, I shot Zarek's champion, Lord Cardock. A clean kill through the eye at some thousand yards. Not that there's anything clever about shooting someone in the eye, sir.
Oh, goodbye. Only when you are truly worthy as a hero will you be able to ascend to the higher level of this hall. When you have paid homage to all of the heroes in the lower hall, the ghostly stairs will then become solid.
So, even from the shackles of death, my old enemy pursues me. You're too late, Fortescue. Already my army has risen from the grave. You will never leave this necropolis.
Some obstructions can be smashed down with clubs and certain other weapons. Try experimenting. These boulders are going to crush your bones if you aren't careful. I hope you have a good shield equipped. Remember that each hit on your shield will chip away at its durability. Better it than you, though. of great archaeological interest. Destroy the boulder and plunder the valuable treasures within. The club is a crude but effective weapon. Bash with it, burn with it, but beware, one bash too many, and it will break.
A coven of the warty old hags lived here once, unholy fires burning all night while they brewed up unspeakable muck in their cauldrons. They moved on years back, but the smell still makes our eyes sting.
A guide to covens for witches and witchcraft enthusiasts. A witch's coven would reach the height of its power only when all of their sacred flames were alight. Witches have been known to offer help to the questing adventurer, yet they are a reclusive people and have to be summoned by the aid of mystic charms or talismans. Let it be known that help from a witch is rarely given freely, and the witch will more often than not make a request of the adventurer before any such help is given. If seeking to summon a witch, remember that they are quite territorial. Any signs of previous witch activity in an area is a good indication that a witch can be called upon. Thank you. Of course. A guide to covens for witches and witchcraft enthusiasts. A witch's coven would reach the height of its power only when all of their sacred flames were alight. Witches have been known to offer help to the questing adventurer, yet they are a reclusive people and have to be summoned. Thank you.
kill the monster, we give our lives.
The adventurer would be wise to be thorough in the exploration of an area. Hidden locations reap great rewards.
Back from the battle so soon? It must think it is a hero by now. But only a true hero is worthy of a place in the Hall of Heroes. See the ghostly statue of your fraudster self? When it has turned solid, a true hero you will be.
Take more than the army of the evil dead to throw your strides up. I have something that may help you on your quest, Captain. I give it to you freely, though I have no idea what it is.
You are entering a house of pain. Rumors abound of evil doings in the secret catacombs below this very hall.
Thank you.
Watch out for sticky-fingered imps. These thieves will strip you down to your armored undies. Rumor has it they fence their stolen wares with the merchant gargoyles. The stained glass demon is the master of the mausoleum. His wretched soul lies preserved inside a frozen glass heart. Shrouded in a veil of darkness beneath the mausoleum, you will find this pre-frozen menace. The would-be phantom longs to play a new tune, but he seems doomed to repeat the same cause of despair over and over.
Thank you.
It's the Hall of Heroes shopping mall. Bargain hunters should check out the ground floor. Well-to-do shoppers should check out the upper floor. That's where it's at.
What's this I hear about that Archcad Zarok still being alive? Thought you killed the fella. Never mind, you old warhorse. Better show him what's what, eh? I expect Johnny's zombies a bit more of a handful than you remember. How are you doing for weapons? Here, take my warhammer. It'll smash anything and it won't fall apart like a club. I only ever get to use it cracking walnuts around this place. Nonsense, Fortescue! I won't take no for an answer! Knock a few heads for old Stand Your Iron Hewer, eh?
Want to be faster on your feet? Want to be able to bash down walls by charging into them? All you have to do is defeat the evil guardians of the graveyard and gain this new ability. You will never know why you left the grave without it.
Has changed outside the necropolis. Pearls go this way, pearls go that way. Nasty, painful death waits round every turn and over every hill. Bon voyage. It's the Hall of Heroes shopping mall. Bargain hunters should...
Bravo, Fortescue! Some of the other chaps wagered Zarok would be using your ribcage as a toast rack by now. But I knew you'd pull through. Here, I have a little extra something here I can give you. Could help the old quest. You want it?
Back in King Peregrine's day, imps were often kept as household servants. Sadly, those were cruel times, and many imps were treated very poorly by their masters. Really, it was no surprise when these cunning little creatures formed a secret alliance with Xerok. On the morning of the Battle of Galamir, every last one of King Peregrine's men awoke to find his house imp gone, and along with them, every last undergarment in the kingdom. Never before had an army's charge been so devastatingly broken before battle had even begun. There used to be a coven of witches in the caves beneath Cemetery Hill. The whole forest never smelled the same since.
Who has summoned the Witch of the Forest? Oh, it is you, Sir Fortescue. Forgive me, my lord. I have never met a real hero. Forgive me, just an old lady's little joke. In truth, I am glad to see you, Sir Fortescue. I need 7 pieces of amber that are hidden in the ant's nest. Bring them to me, and I can grant you a special reward. I will only offer you this quest this once. Are you willing to give it a try? Sorry, didn't I mention I'd have to shrink you to the size of an insect? Now hurry back.
Run, little man. If the master found it now, he would crush it like a bag. Hark! We can hear the soldier ants approaching. Onward, and meet your tiny nemesis.
This magic portal was crafted by the fairies. It appears to have been created to prevent something escaping from the tunnels below. If you are brave enough to go beyond this point, you will enter the chamber of the dreaded Queen Ant.
Okay,